Hello everybody. This time I'm going to work on the tubes, the fuel lines and vent lines from the left and right wing tanks. Okay, we have to start with the big holes in the most inboard ribs, and there are special plates for that. The plates are both, you could say, identical for the left and the right tank. However, I need to make a different one for the left tank, because I make a full aerobatic plane, which means that you need a flop tube, which is a tube that can get fuel from the tank even when you're inverted. So I start with the right tank, as you can see here, because that's, let's say, according to plan. So that's kind of standard. It's the easy one. Deburring all the holes, and then I can fit the fuel pickup plates. You have to countersink the rivet holes. And then I had to figure out for the left tank. First, my option was to just close the holes of the original plate. But later I thought, nah, that's not a good idea. Let's get a whole new plate altogether. So I created my own plate for that without any holes in there, which is probably a better idea anyway. So. Kind of imagine that if I didn't cut the holes in the first place, I wouldn't have to close them now. So I think it's kind of obsolete to do it this way, but okay. The plan said I needed to create a trap door in the second rib. Not exactly where it is for, probably to hold fuel or prevent fuel from flowing back. I'm not sure. I mean, there's fuel in there, so somehow there's probably a way to prevent running fuel, but I'm not sure. Anyway, I just thought I'm going to create a trapdoor and see how it happens. It's a good thing you've got some excess of some materials like piano hinges and other stuff that come in handy now. Yeah, testing the trapdoor works very well, so I'm okay with it. Now the fuel senders, so the fuel level, you can measure the fuel level with that, and the fuel caps. Plans are very, how do you say, very brief, so you have to think about how it should fit. So here I'm drilling the fuel cap in there. This is the left wing. You have to create some kind of small, some small holding hook for the vent line. Again, building it from scrap material. Now I have to do it for the other wing too. I had a fuel drain flanges, I also needed to do that. So I use a drill, a big drill, with some tape around it to get it exactly centered into the hole. There were no other ways to do it, so that's the way I do it. Now I also do it immediately in the right wing. So first I drill the drain. Okay, cleaning up. And the second part of this video was on the few days later. And because it was all about the same type of work, I made one video of it. You see me read a lot here, but that's because it's quite hard to understand all the plans. It's written on only one page, I think, so it's very, very concise. And that's just one drawing. It's not that easy. I don't hope the plans get more condensed than this, because that will be harder. Okay, there's some inventory for next time. And reading ahead, because I didn't really understand what I needed to do there. Okay, so this is the next day. And now I'm actually trying to figure out how the bulkheads need to be inserted. I did it wrong several times because I wasn't really sure what side should go in or out, but once you understand it, it's actually easy. Then you can see, and now I understand the picture, the drawing. So I used the saw to saw the fuel pickup line. Later I learned that you shouldn't do it, you should use a specific cutter for that. So I will recut that part. Okay, so now I have to make a hole for the vent line, the fuel vent line, because if you suck fuel out of a tank, of course you will need to refill it with air. So you can see the most right inboard rib ready with the vent line and the fuel pickup line. The left one is harder because again they're the flop tube. So now I'm going to address that part. The vent line is similar, so there's no problem there. It's the same procedure. However, the flop tube is very long, as you can see. It's almost just as long as the rib itself. So you need to insert it all the way on the front of the rib, which means you need to cut through the very thick holding angle there, the tank attach angle. So first I drill with a very small drill and then I make the hole bigger and bigger. First in the doubler than the rib itself, and also in the tank attach angle. Right. Well, the result was actually quite good, so I'm really glad with that. Almost finished with all the preparations. There are a lot of preparations before you can start stealing the tanks, but I'm almost done, so that's good. I just have to flare the tubes and yeah, then I'm done. And of course, dimpling all the skins, but that's more work. Great. Next time, flaring the tubes. Building my pie in the sky.